when you start walking in His truth, you will start to not only save money, but there'll be some things that you won't spend money on, like pharmaceuticals and hospital visits, when you walk in His truth. Because the truth of the matter is, Jesus, who was made sin for us, who knew no sin, that we could become the righteousness of God in Him, bore our sickness, infirmity, and diseases on the cross. Amen? So where is the sickness and infirmity and diseases and even death? It's on the cross. Now, wait a minute. He ain't going back to the cross to redo that for you, because you just found out. It was done 2,000 years ago, and when you walk in the truth, then the things of the devil can't exist in you, because you resist the devil and he will flee. He'll come in one way and have to flee seven different ways, because you are being joyful and he's being joyful in you, because you're walking in his truth.
I want to thank you for tuning in, and I want you to stay tuned for a powerful message that's on its way. I'm talking about staying connected to the Holy Spirit. The Bible says to grieve not the Holy Spirit, whereby we are sealed into the day of redemption. Do you realize that the Holy Spirit is a gentleman? He's not going to go where he's not wanted or not where he's appreciated. When we see in Genesis chapter 1, when God said, "Let there be light," the Spirit of the Lord was moving upon the darkness, waiting on the command. Soon as God spoke it, Holy Spirit produced it. Holy Spirit is waiting right here for you to speak the word of God that's already in heaven, forever settled. There's power in agreement. When we speak what thus saith the Lord concerning our life and our situation, Holy Spirit is right there to produce the word, to produce it to life. Over in John 1 and 14, it says, the word became flesh and dwelt among us. I want you to get your pens, your paper, your pads. Call a friend. Tell them we're on, because this is a powerful message coming up. And you stay tuned and be blessed. Amen. I'll see you when the program's over.
And as you have heard that the Antichrist shall come, even now are there many Antichrists, whereby we know that it is the last time that they went out from us, but they were not of us. So don't complain when the people who started with you don't end up with you. For if they had been of us, they would not no doubt have continued with us. But they went out, that might be made manifest that we were not all, that they were not all of us. But you have an unction from the Holy One, and ye know all things, and I have not written unto you because you know not the truth, but because you know it. And that no lie is in the truth. Who is a liar but he that denieth that Jesus is the Christ? He is the Antichrist that denieth the Father and the Son. You have people that you know, not necessarily be of the world, but be in the church as well, that deny Jesus Christ as Lord. Wait a minute. Jesus said it this way. He says, they honor me with their lips, but their heart be far from me. If that be the case, people can sit right in the church and still deny Jesus Christ. Because if people hate you, I can say this with a clear conscience. If I do the work of God, why is it that you hate me? If you hate me, then that's not you really hating me. You hating the one that sent me. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Because I do the work of the Lord. See, you know how you can go to church and you can shout, You can glorify God, and you can say amen to everything that the pastor say out of his mouth. But as soon as he say one thing that shows you you, you say the Lord then showed you this ain't the church for you no more. Last time I checked, God don't be changing his mind every 5 minutes, amen. He chastens those whom he loves, amen. And if you can put your mouth on a pastor or a man of God that's doing the work of God, then Christ really ain't in you. Somebody say amen to that. I hear preachers say stuff on TV all the time that I don't think necessarily line up with the truth. But if they've been called by God, I'm not their judge. Last time I checked, he says, touch not my anointing and do my prophets no harm. If a person is anointed to preach the gospel, sometimes they might have stayed up all night, might have got the wrong thing in their spirit, might have got up in the morning and preached the wrong thing. Remember, they're human too. If we're connected to his Holy Spirit, what happens in us if we see our brother in error, we've been given a mandate to restore them. Amen. Somebody say amen. Amen. It ain't our job to bust them out or to slander them. It's our job to restore. Amen. Somebody say amen to that. Amen. I don't necessarily go around trying to correct everybody. I say, Lord, if I correct them, they're going to be mad at me. But if you correct them, that takes me off the hook. Somebody say amen to that. So I let him fight my battles for me. Do you know how much that free you up? Amen. Come on, some of y'all just got deliverance and breakthrough from that. When you let the Lord fight your battles, do you know how much free time you have now when you ain't got to worry about it? Because if God be for me, who can be a... See, now, if you know how the Spirit of Truth operates, there'll be some things that you just won't participate in. Amen. Amen. Come on, now, you have more time to participate in prayer. Sometimes you say, well, I don't know when I'm going to find time to pray and read the Word. Well, when you stop taking time for all them negative people and all the negative things that they're saying, when you begin to erase that and put up a shield that it don't bother you no more, then all the time that you were spending on that, you can now find that time to get in the Word and get before the Lord. Somebody say amen. Because we don't worship the God of other folks' opinions. Somebody say amen to that. Look at what it says over here in 3 John chapter 1. 3 John chapter 1. I'm going to go into Romans 8 in a minute, but I need to lay this foundation down. 3 John chapter 1, it says, in verse 3, it says, for I rejoice greatly when the brethren come and testify of the truth that is in thee, even as thou walkest in the truth, for I have no greater joy than to hear that my children walk in truth. How can you walk in truth and you don't know the truth? How can you walk in truth and you don't know the truth? But he says, I have a great joy when my children walk in the truth. Now, the truth of the matter is, the Bible says that God is true. Right. And let every man be a... So if we want to know the truth of God, we find it through his word. Amen. And if we find it in his word and we walk in it, then God is joyful that we're walking in the truth as his children. Because this is how we show the world that we are his children, because we walk in his truth. When we walk in his truth, then the... Oh, Jesus. Thank you, Holy Spirit. God just spoke to me. He says, when you start walking in his truth, you will start to not only save money, but there'll be some things that you won't spend money on, like pharmaceuticals and hospital visits, when you walk in his truth. Because the truth of the matter is, Jesus, who was made sin for us, who knew no sin, that we could become the righteousness of God in him, bore our sickness, infirmity, and diseases on the cross. Amen? So where is the sickness and infirmity and diseases and even death? It's on the cross. Now, wait a minute. He ain't going back to the cross to redo that for you, because you just found out. It was done 2,000 years ago, and when you walk in the truth, then the things of the devil can't exist in you, because you resist the devil and he will flee. He'll come in one way and have to flee seven different ways, because you are being joyful and he's being joyful in you because you're walking in his truth.
Amen.
When you're walking in his truth, I don't care if it seems like a reality. Y'all remember that they had this program on TV, and Michael Jackson was doing all this stuff on some new songs, and he wasn't really there. But it was a hologram, and everybody was like, oh, Mike then came back from the dead. But we know that's not a truth. That was an untruth appearing real. There are so many untruths that appear in your life that are not real, just waiting on your acceptance. How many know that when you sign for the package, now it belongs to you? That's how the devil comes. He comes as the UPS man. Got a package for you. Sign for it right here. How many of you have received an evil report about some kind of sickness or something like that, or some bad news about something, and then you go around telling everybody it's yours? Come on, don't shout me down right here, because I'm preaching good, because I'm preaching better than you saying amen. If you brought amen with you and you got one in your purse or your wallet, now it's time for you to use it right there. Now it's the time you pull that out and say amen, pastor. Glory to God. Look at what it says over here in 2 Corinthians chapter 13 and verse 7. 2 Corinthians chapter 13 and verse 7. It says, now I pray to God that you do no evil, not that we should appear approved, but that they should do that which is honest, though we be as reprobate. For we can do nothing against the truth, but for the truth. For we are glad when we are weak, and ye are strong, and this also we wish, even your perfection. Therefore I write these things, being absent, lest being present, that I should use the sharpness according to the power which the Lord hath given me to the edification and not to the destruction. He says, I pray that you do no evil. But that is good. Now, when you say my back is killing me, you just did some evil. When you say my head is killing me, or my feet. Now, really, now here's this is what we need to come to the truth about. Because death and life are in the power of the tongue. And those that love it shall eat the fruit thereof, because fruit comes from the seed that's spoken out of your mouth. It's going to produce something. There's going to be a harvest that comes from it. Amen.
Right.
So now here when he says do no evil, because when you do evil, you're going to reap some evil and you'll wind up eating what you reap, because that's the harvest. What do you do with harvest? You consume harvest. Somebody say amen to that. And if you're always going around confessing the negative thing, that's what you're going to continue to eat, and that's what's going to be in your heart. And the Bible says, out of the issues of the heart, the mouth speaks. That's why you have to guard this thing with all diligence, because out of this are the issues of life. Amen? Issues are things that we give focus to other than the truth. Come on now, see, I've heard people say, Pastor, I ain't gonna be able to make it to church today because I'm a little under the weather. And I'm like, really? You should be jumping up like a jack-in-the-box, springing to come into the house of the Lord to get your healing and deliverance because you feel like you're a little under the weather. Now, see, now that's a person that's doing evil. I know y'all probably like, Pastor, you done gone off the deep end now. Now, remember, he says, let not no corrupt communication proceed out of thy mouth, but that which is good and edifying, that it may lift up. Come on now, and if you're saying something that's contrary to the truth, Holy Spirit can't help you. Holy Spirit can't help you, because he's only going to produce your agreement with the word. See, when you're not in agreement with the word and you're speaking sight and circumstance, the Holy Spirit stands back. And the Bible says, grieve him not. Don't grieve the Holy Spirit. And every time we're speaking contrary to what the truth says, we're grieving the Holy Spirit. Somebody say amen to that. Hallelujah. Saints should say what Jesus spoke in the earth. You know they came to Jesus because Jairus' daughter appeared to be dead. Remember they say, trouble the master no more because the damsel is dying. Jesus said, no, she's just asleep. Yep. I'll go and wake her. You know, and it was, she dead. Notice he didn't agree with what they were talking about. Right. See, he was in his own right calling things which be not as though they appear. See, every report ain't a good report. Romans chapter 12 tells us to prove that which is good and acceptable and the perfect will of God. And if you're not taking the time out to take it through this filtration process, you'll just grab a hold of anything. The devil is banking on you not thinking for yourself. He likes it when you don't think. He likes it when you don't give it a second thought. He likes it when you just go for the thing that you think that you have no control over. But let me tell you this. The Bible says, as he is, so are we here in the earth. So if he said, peace, be still, you can say, peace, be still. If he says, according to your faith, you've been made whole, you can say, according to your faith, you've been made whole. Jesus. Jesus didn't trip when he didn't have no money because he always had some. Money was never an issue. Money was never an issue with Jesus, even though the Bible says he became poor. But how do you become poor? You had to be rich in order to become poor. But you got some people that will stand on that and think that you are supposed to be poor because Jesus became poor. But before he became poor, he was rich. The Bible says he was rich, but became poor, yet through his poverty that you could become rich. Ah. See, now, if you're not operating in the truth, then you will think you broke. And if you think you broke, you will say you broke. And if you say you broke, you broke. I don't care if I don't see no money. That don't mean I'm broke. If I don't see no money, that means I need to put a demand on some. That means I need to call some, amen? I need to remind God of what he said. I got some seed in the ground. I ain't seen no harvest. Now I need to remind the devil of what God said. He says, if the thief be found, he's got to recompense me sevenfold and empty out the contents of his house. That's when I don't see no finances. Oh, devil, I'm about to shake you down. What you holding over here? Amen. Not only am I finna shake the devil down that's in the earth, but I'm getting ready to call down some finances that's stored up in heaven. Because he said, lay up for yourself treasures in heaven, amen? So I got some treasure in both places. I got some treasure here in the earth. Matter of fact, I got more treasure here in the earth because the Bible says my daddy owned the cattle on 1,000 hills. So everything in this earth that he made belonged to me because he says the Spirit of God will search the deep things of God. He'll search what's mine and then show it to you. How can you ask for what you don't know you're entitled to unless the Holy Spirit come and say, yep, it's plenty of it up here. Put it in store. Put it demand on it. Glory to God. Boy, if I tell you how much my wife and my daughter ask me for stuff. And I'm like, will y'all give me a break? They never give me a break because they know some stuff. See, if they don't know you possess it, they won't ask for it. If you always talking about you broke, then now you the wrong source. But whenever my daughter come to me and I tell her no, she'd be like, Daddy, you got it. It's in that wallet. If it ain't in that wallet, it's in one of them cards. You can take one of them cards and get what I'm asking for. If it's something on my plate, She don't ask me. She just walk over to my plate and grab what she want. If I got a cup or a glass or something sitting there, man, I just look up and see a little hand. Just, and she drinks sideways. I was like, okay, you done with that? Now, wait a minute. She only does that because she knows that she's entitled. Yeah. Wait a minute. The Bible says that you are children of God. Amen. Says that you're an heir of God. And also says you're a joint heir. Some of you better get like bruh, man. Just chilling, eating up everything that's inside. Amen. Come on, some of you need to change your mentality because it ain't like God has a shortage. Amen. Amen. But only his spirit of truth can show you what you are entitled to. Remember, the Bible says, if our gospel be hid, it's hid unto those whose minds are blinded by the God of this world. And if you don't know what you're entitled to, it's because either you're ignorant, you have not studied out the world, or the word, or either the enemy has got the mind, your mind blinded, and you can't see it. You know, you might have people that you tell them what God can do for them and how God can bless them and how God can change them and how God can turn their situation around, and they look at you like you're crazy because they don't believe it. Bible says, how can they receive the spirit of truth because they don't know him? They don't know the spirit of truth. They don't even know that he exists. Remember, Paul says, have you received the Holy Ghost since you believe? They said, we have not even heard there is a Holy Ghost. He says, whose baptism have you been baptized by? He said, baptism of John.
Listen, if you would like to get a copy of that message, it's a 5-part series, Staying Connected to the Holy Spirit. Actually, for your love gift of $30 or more, I'm going to send you the 5-disc CD set. And for your love gift of $50 or more, I'm going to send you the 5-disc DVD set. Now, as my way of saying thank you for even watching the program and to sowing into this ministry, I'm going to send you an additional 3 copies of an additional teaching of Staying Connected to the Holy Spirit, which you'll get 8 discs in all, either or, CD or DVD. And it's to help us to keep the gospel of Jesus Christ on the air. And that's our way of saying thank you. You can get with us by sending the request to P.O. Box 757, Bolingbrook, Illinois, just by simply making the request, Staying Connected to the Holy Spirit. We'll get it out to you right away. Or you can call us at 630-243-4298. There is a prayer warrior on the phone right now waiting on your call. Amen. So call us and let us know how the program has blessed you, or call us to receive prayer, and also call us to order today's copy of the message that you just saw. Praise the Lord. I want to make sure you have the right relationship with our Lord Jesus Christ. If you've never received Jesus as Lord, then it's simple to be born again. Just repeat this prayer after me. Father God, I believe that Jesus is your Son, and that he died, and that you rose him again on the 3rd day. Jesus, come into my heart. Live in my life. I accept you as my Lord and Savior. Now, if you said that simple prayer, you just got born again. I want you to get into a Bible-believing, Bible-teaching church and get the Word of God. If you don't have a church home, I invite you to come by Ultimate Faith Christian Center. We're located at 683 East 83rd Street in Bolingbrook at the corner of James Avenue. Remember, there's always a warm seat of a welcome waiting on you right here at Ultimate Faith Christian Center. Hey, I'll see you the next time. Remember to walk by faith and not by sight.
Join Apostle George Guilford and Ultimate Faith Christian Center for their 2014 Faith and Vision Conference starting Wednesday, November 5th. With guest speaker Pastor Daryl Barnett, pastor of Faith Life Christian Center in Minneapolis, Minnesota. Thursday, November 6th, our guest speaker will be Bishop Kenneth Coleman, pastor of City of Refuge Pentecostal Church in Joliet, Illinois, and from the TV series, The Preacher's Daughters. On Friday, November 7th, our guest speaker will be Apostle Ron Wilson from Full Gospel Christian Assemblies International in Hazel Crest, Illinois.
But in the kingdom of God, amen, there's rules and regulation. And one of the rules in the kingdom of God is that every man must pray. Every believer has to have a prayer life. Where there is no prayer, there is no power.
Joining us Saturday, November 8th, will be Apostle John Abercrombie from Truth and Deliverance International Church in Chicago, Illinois.
Satan has what? Has desire. to have you, that he may send you. The NIV says, he has asked me that he may sift you like wheat. Now notice, Jesus didn't say, I'm not going to let him do it. But he said, but I have prayed for you.
And on Sunday, November 9th, our very own Apostle George Guilford will be wrapping it up with a powerful message that you would not want to miss.
The things that you can do, he's going to let you do. It's the things that you can't do, that's when he'll step in. See, God can't get the glory out of you being able to move the chair, because he know you can do that. But when it comes to moving the mountain, then you know you can't do that.
Oh, Jesus.
See, that's when God comes in, because he know you ain't got the strength or the know-how or the machinery to move a mountain. So he moved the mountain for you. He said, I just need you to believe me that I'm able to do it. Now you speak to it and I'm going to back you up.
This powerful conference will be held at Ultimate Faith Christian Center, 683 East 83rd Street in Bolingbrook, Illinois. Services will be held nightly at 7 p.m. and are open to the public. Doors are open at 6 p.m. Child care would not be available. Mark your calendar for the 2014 Faith and Vision Conference, starting Wednesday, November 5th, Thursday, November 6th, Friday, November 7th, Saturday, November 8th, and Sunday, November 9th. This event will be held at Ultimate Faith Christian Center, 683 East 83rd Street in Bolingbrook, Illinois. We'll see you there.
If any of you lack wisdom, let him ask of God, that giveth to all men liberally, and upbraideth not, and it shall be given him. But let him ask in faith, nothing wavering. For he that wavers is like a wave of the sea, driven with the wind, and tossed. For let not that man think that he shall receive anything of the Lord. A double-minded man is unstable in all his ways.
In this series, Laying the Axe to the Root of a Double Mind, Apostle Guilford breaks down the tentacles of the roots that causes men to be double-minded. Fear, doubt, unbelief, hardness of heart, reasoning, and unforgiveness are a few of the topics that are discussed in this powerful series. Learn how to hear from God and taking back the control of your thought life by renewing your mind through God's Word. Order your set today, which includes 5 CDs for your love gift of $25 or more, or order the 5 DVD series for $50 or more. Call or write us and request offer entitled Laying an Axe to the Root. Call 630-243-4298. The prayer partners are waiting to receive your call. Or send your request to George Guilford Ministries, P.O. Box 757, Bolingbrook, Illinois 60440.